Hey everyone, I'm Lauren Reese alongside my co-host Chris Jenkins. We're in front of Bank of America Stadium right now, about to take on the Philadelphia Eagles. I'm super excited. How are you feeling?
A little hot. A little ready to go, though.
Yeah, it's definitely hot.
Always hot every single week.
So right? I was looking forward to it to being a little bit cooler. The temperature says it's cooler, but I don't feel like it's cooler.
If you look over in this direction, it looks really, really beautiful.
Oh, it's a perfect day for football, definitely. But when you're sitting in the beating sun, it's still perfect, but we're just a little bit warm.
Yeah.
But typically the show is live and interactive. We're able to take your questions, answer anything you have to say. We did have a few technical difficulties today. Again, we're going to work it out, I promise. So hopefully next week, fingers crossed, everything will be good to go and we'll be able to go live and take your questions, answer anything you have, you're wondering, questioning about. We're here for you.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to play the lottery, win $1 million, so that when we come out here, Lauren and I will have a whole production team. We'll have a van over here. We'll have guys holding mics and blocking the sun and never have any problems again. But I guess until then, there may be some problems.
Until then, you can deal with us right now, right?
Yeah.
Well, we're still here for you. Yeah. Regardless if we're able to go live or not, we'll still record a video like we're doing today just so you can get all the information before the game, because we want you to get to know everything we have to say and update you on all the important things before the game. So there are transactions since Friday. They elevated Kenny Robinson and Rodney Smith to the active roster with standard COVID elevation for week 5. And these two NFC teams are both coming off of losses. We lost for the first time last week to the Dallas Cowboys, and the Eagles also lost to the Kansas City Chiefs. So both teams coming off losses, but I have a good feeling about today, and I think we're going to get another win.
You got a prediction on the score, right?
I do have a prediction. I'll give it to you right now. I'll give it to you early on.
I'm
predicting Panthers win 23 to 20. That was my prediction. If you saw it on Twitter, you caught it. Here it is again. Let's see how my prediction pans out. What are you predicting?
I don't predict scores. Right?
You can predict it in your head.
I'll let you do that, but I do feel good about a victory today.
Okay,
I do
perfect.
Feel good about that.
Well, our Panthers are now 3-1,
yes.
And the Cowboys are, we lost to the Cowboys, but the Eagles are flopped that. They are 1-3,
yeah.
So let's hope we can...
flop that? I like that.
Yeah, flopped, you know, like just flop the numbers around to the other side, and that's the Eagles record. But so the Panthers are, they're 3-1, and we have played Philadelphia 12 times, which I thought it was less than that, but I guess not.
Okay.
But
that's
12. Philly does lead, unfortunately, 7-5, but hopefully we're going to change that.
7-6 after today.
7-6 after today. There you go. So we do every week interesting facts, so I'm going to give you some right now. The average time of possession is 34 minutes and 48 seconds.
And that's worked out well for us most of the year.
Really has. And we have the second highest point differential in the first half.
And you know, something interesting about that is Philadelphia also plays really good in the first half as well, mm-hmm. and kind of fall off in the second half. So we might see like a 30 to 28 score in the first half. And then, you know, whoever finally plays a good full game will have the points in the second half and win.
Yeah.
So that's, I guess, my subliminal message to say, don't get too excited if it's a high scoring first half and it's close.
Definitely. So also we have totaled 98 first downs and we're tied for fourth.
Tied for fourth with that, yeah. We're doing good. We're doing some good things.
And this is not a shocker. Sam Darnold leads the NFL in rushing TDs with how many?
How is that not a shocker?
How many? Because it is not a shocker, because we all expected Sam after week 1 and 2 to perform like he's performing. Like, it is not a shocker at all to me.
But running the ball?
Okay.
Passing, yeah. Running the ball?
Okay. It's a little bit of a shocker, but it's not a shocker to me because I believed in Sam. So I'm just going to say that. It's probably a shocker to almost everyone else, I guess Chris included, but not me, because I believed in Sam all along.
Okay. Hey, there's your sun cover.
Oh my gosh, we just got a little bit of shade, and it is glorious. It is glorious. Okay, another thing for Sam is Sam holds the active streak of 300-yard passing games.
Can I steal this from you again?
Yeah.
Like, I stole it from her before, but you guys don't know
that. Here comes the sun.
Yeah, here comes the sun. Sam, so you can say you expected this stat, perhaps, but Sam Darnold has the current streak right now, the end of an active streak for 300-plus passing yards with 3, and I feel like it's a pretty good chance to extend that today to make it 4.
I'm still not shocked with how Sam performed. I feel like coming off his previous seasons, this was to be expected. He was going to ball out, go crazy, do his thing, and that's exactly what he's done.
So when we're in the Super Bowl down in – where's the Super Bowl? Is it in
– It's in L.A., SoFi Stadium.
Okay. You've already planned it out.
Fingers crossed we're going to be there because we'll get to see that new beautiful stadium.
So you will not be surprised if me and you are in L.A. Mid-February. soaking up the sun and beaches and doing a little reporting, huh?
I won't be surprised, and Sam will be running touchdowns into the end zone.
Hey, can we say you'll be back home?
Oh, yeah, I'll be back home because that's where I'm from, my old stomping grounds. I grew up, born and raised Orange County, California, which is like 30 minutes from the stadium.
There you go.
That would be the dream. So let's keep our fingers crossed that that ends up happening because that would be lovely. But let's go into our current top 10 NFL rankings. I'm going to do the offense because I always stick with the defense. I love the defense, so I'll give Chris the defense this time. I'll do the offense, though.
All right, what's that?
Passing net yards per game, 280. Eighth. We're eighth.
Yeah.
Okay, that was short for the offense. So Chris is going to give you a ton on the defense because normally I'm doing all the talking for defense, but we're going to switch it up today and give it to Chris.
So I'm going to give a break on the mic. Defense, now we had a big slide from going to first place and everything last week. Dallas really put it on us pretty big, mostly in the rushing department, but I'm going to go through these stats. Might go through them a little quick because we're behind schedule. We got to get in here to the stadium and start reporting for the game itself. So here you go. Total yards allowed per game, we're at 251. Good for third place overall in the NFL. Rushing yards per game. Now, this is where we took the biggest hit. We were number one with 45 yards. Dak and Ezekiel Elliott pretty much had that in the first quarter last week. So that's changed a lot, but we're currently still in 10th spot with 95 yards per game that we're allowing. Passing net yards per game, 156 yards, so that's good for second place in the NFL. Sacks, even though we didn't get any, we got absolutely zero, but that tells you how good this defense has been playing up until this point. We're still at 14. That's still good enough for first place in the NFL. Lauren is going to tell you that number is going to grow today.
But that number is going to change because we are going to get sacks today, and I'm predicting 3 sacks. Let's hope for more, but I'm predicting it's going to be 3. I'm feeling Burns is going to have a sack, and I'm not going to give the other two a who I think, but I'm going to tell Chris, and then he can come on after and tell you if I was correct.
Third down efficiency, we're in first place. Points allowed per game, we're in third place overall in the NFL, so still pretty good on the defensive side. And then we also do notable connections, like where we talk about players or coaches from the previous team that's currently on the other team that's playing today. Don't have any today, so we'll let you take over for the next spot.
All right, we're going to try to speed through this because we are a little bit behind today. So I'm going to – yeah, we're a lot. Let's be real. We're a lot behind. So normally we – go through this a little bit slower, but it's going to be a little bit rushed, but it's okay. So we're going to read through things to watch. I'm going to do 3, you can do 3.
All right.
Does that work?
We're upping it, huh?
Perfect. We're upping it because we got to get moving.
Yes.
So today, will Sam Darnold continue to be our red zone solution?
Yes, he will. Sam is the man.
He held us to be 100% last week, 4
yes.
for 4.
Yeah.
Sam is that man. He is that man with rushing. DJ Moore, right, is second in receptions in the NFL.
Smith, spirit animal.
Not a shocker to me. DJ is amazing. And he's fourth in receiving yards, by the way.
Okay,
question. Will the Eagles come out in the jumbo sets with 3 tight ends that we saw with the Cowboys due to get such a huge advantage?
I think they'd be a fool not to try it. I mean, you saw the Cowboys did something different on both the defense and offense up front, and it affected us big time. So, and even our defensive coordinator mentioned that he expects them to do it, so we got to see if we're going to respond.
Definitely. Okay, now I'm going to have you talk a little bit about C.J. Henderson.
Okay, let me go to my notes.
He's got to go to his notes.
Go to my notes.
A little flustered after our little, what do you want to call it? Mishap?
I don't know what to call
mishap.
It. I'll make
technical
another video
difficulty.
Just telling you guys, but actually I don't even want to explain anything anymore. I just want stuff to be right. But C.J. Henderson will be playing today. Don't have a lot other than he's a guy to watch as we see what he's going to do with his second week with us, right?
Mm-hmm.
That'll be good to see. Everybody's excited about the Stephon Gilmore trade. You know, he's going to be out for 2 games. So
that's still exciting.
Yeah, out next week versus Minnesota, but should be able to play versus the New York Giants.
Yeah, Carolina native, South Carolina, Rock Hill.
Yes.
He's coming home.
Yes.
Well, he is home now. He's home.
Cue the song, coming home.
Oh,
Javon Hargrove, hope I said his name right, for the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, he's on their defensive line. He's been playing pretty good, getting a lot of pressure on quarterbacks with sacks. I think he has about 4 quarterback hits. I know he has more hits than sacks. So the interesting thing here to watch is that Cam Irvin's going to be out. Normally he'd be up against Javon. And so we're going to have some rookies potentially in place. I know a lot of people want to see Brady Christensen or Deontay. Who knows? Coach Rule wouldn't say. But seeing how we play with that matchup will be something to watch today. And then lastly, I got Jalen Hurts. He can move.
He can move.
Yeah, he can move. Dak Prescott can move a little bit too.
Mm-hmm.
So this will be interesting to see how our defense goes to contain that mobile quarterback. And you got one more spot. You want to do a coin flip to see who's going to say the last
Birds,
one?
Baby.
Yeah. Fly, Eagles, fly.
No.
I mean, I'm just saying.
No.
That's what they do. Laura says no.
You, what did you say? You want me to predict something?
No, I'm going to, the last thing to watch, so I'm going to cover it.
Okay, you can, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, give me that mic back. There, let's see, interesting facts.
Yeah.
I lost my spot where things to watch. I don't have any more because we actually covered it all.
Yeah, that's so where I'm like, I don't know what else you want me to cover, but I think we covered everything.
We covered everything. So I'll go ahead and wrap this up since we got to go in. So I'm Chris Jenkins, Lauren Rez. Hey, really appreciate you guys. It is, I didn't want to say anything about the technical difficulties, but I have to because you noticed that we had a live broadcast. Only went for 38 seconds. I don't know, a cable this time went on me. Who knows? But guess what? I can tell you this. Lauren isn't going to quit trying to do this, making it work. I'm not going to quit, so I hope that you guys will not quit and continue to stay tuned with us as we work through things. And tune in to Twitter. Please tune in to Twitter during the game. Lots of good information that we'll put out there, all right? So we're going to go in. For Lauren Ruiz, I'm Chris Jenkins with Charlotte Vibe. We'll see you shortly.